Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 1726 of our daily Naseehah and advice. Today, with the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala, we focus on the 11th of Muharram. It was on the 11th of Muharram, 694 after Hijrah, corresponding to the 1st December 1294. King Al-Adil Zainuddin Qutbugah Al-Mansuri, the 10th Sultan and ruler of the Mamluk Empire, came into power. He was the first ruler and Sultan to assume the title Amir. Now, yeah, we need to go back in history. After the demise of Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu ruled the Ummah for 2.25 years approximately. So we find that he was called Khalifa to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the direct successor of Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the messenger of Islam, peace be upon him. After his demise, Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu came into power and he was given the title Amirul Mu'mineen. So that is a distinction of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala an. So yeah, we see that this person, King Al-Adil Zainuddin Qutbugah Al-Mansuri, was given the title of Amir. But you can't say Amirul Mu'mineen because for a certain area only he was, not the whole Ummah. So Sayyidina Umar and Sayyidina Usman, Sayyidina Ali and all of them were the whole Ummah basically. So therefore we should understand that difference there. Second one, Mamluk. Mamluk means once upon a time they were slaves and now they had their freedom and then they rose to power and their headquarters was Egypt and from there it spread to Syria, Jordan, Palestine, all these places. This is the system of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala. تُؤْتِي الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَاءُ. Allah gives the rulership, authority, kingdom to whomsoever He wishes. And He snatches it away and takes it away from whomever He wishes. وَتُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُذِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ. And He honors whoever He wishes. He disgraces whoever He wishes. If you take our country, South Africa, 30, 40 years ago, who would think that the whites, the apartheid regime, will lose power and apartheid will be dismantled? But Almighty Allah Jalla Wala humiliates whoever He wants and He gives honor to whomsoever He wishes. So always remember that. Today we might be in power and strength, but same Almighty Allah has warned us, وَتِلْكَ الْأَيَّامُ نُدَاوِلُهَا بَيْنَ النَّاسِ. The zamana, this capital, this time I gave you, we rotate it amongst people. Today we are healthy, Allah forbid, tomorrow we can be very sick. Today we are very happy and we are joyous, but tomorrow we can be very sad and grieving. Today you must remember we are laughing, but tomorrow we can be crying. So all this year you will find in the Quran Sharif, أَدْحَكَ وَأَبْكَى Amata wa ahya. So everything is under the control, the majesty, authority, supremacy, and sovereignty of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala. Therefore, Muslim, always ask Allah, Allahumma inni as'aluka al-afiya. Oh Allah, I beg of thee afiya, goodness, comfort, protection of Iman, Islam, everything a person will normally relish and cherish for. Simple word afiya and plural for ourselves, our families, Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-afiyah, the plural, and we ask for collectively. So in that way, the encyclopedic meaning. So great, great lesson for all of us, how in Islam slaves become prime ministers, amir and rulers and kings. May Almighty Allah Jalla Wala give us the true understanding of our Deenul Islam, and we learn the history, so that will then motivate and inspire us for the future. Barakallahu fiik. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.